Since love is Lord's of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? Through all the tumult and the strife, I hear that music ringing. It sounds and echoes in my soul. How can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging. Since love is Lord's of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
My brothers and my sisters, as we gather together today, celebrating the goodness of the Lord, celebrating the steadfastness of our faith in him and the Eucharist, we humbly ask that he forgive us of all of our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name. For you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm in the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. Jehoiakim was 18 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 3 months in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Nehushta, daughter of Elnathan of Jerusalem. He did evil in the sight of the Lord, just as his forebears had done. At that time, the officials of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, attacked Jerusalem, and the city came under siege. Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, himself arrived at the city while his servants were besieging it. Then Jehoiakim, king of Judah, together with his mother, his ministers, officers, and functionaries, surrendered to the king of Babylon, who in the 8th year of his reign took him captive. And he carried off all the treasures of the temple of the Lord and those of the palace, and broke up all the gold utensils that Solomon, king of Israel, had provided in the temple of the Lord, as the Lord had foretold. He deported all Jerusalem, all the officers and men of the army, 10,000 in number, and all the craftsmen and smiths. None were left among the people of the land, except the poor. He deported Jehoiakim to Babylon, and also led captive from Jerusalem to Babylon the king's mother and wives, his functionaries, and the chief men of the land. The king of Babylon also led captive to Babylon all 7,000 men of the army, and 1,000 craftsmen and smiths, all of them trained soldiers. In place of Jehoiakim, the king of Babylon appointed his uncle, Mattaniah, king, and changed his name to Zedekiah. Jerusalem, and there is no one to bury them. We have become the reproach of our neighbors, the scorn and derision of those around us. O Lord, how long? Will you be angry forever? Will your jealousy burn like fire? Remember not against us the iniquities of the past. May your compassion quickly come to us, for we are brought very low. For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us. Help us, O God, our Savior, because of the glory of your name. Deliver us and pardon our sins for your name's sake.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. Many will say to me on that day, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy your name? Did we not drive out demons in your name? Did we not do mighty deeds in your name?' Then I will declare to them solemnly, 'I never knew you. Depart from me, you evildoers.' Everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like the wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house. But it did not collapse. It had been set solidly on rock. And everyone who listens to these words of mine, but does not act on them, will be like a fool who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, and it collapsed and was completely ruined." When Jesus finished these words, the crowds were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority, and not as their scribes. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Growing up, it seems like the strongest memories I have of my childhood are, either really good memories or really, bad memories. Those middle-of-the-road sort of things, they just don't really, they don't really have much of a memory for me. And some of the really bad memories, they're really focused on, storms, the scariness of them, going down into the basement as there's a tornado approaching, doing practice drills in school and the sirens going off and like, oh my gosh, what is this happening? As a young child, you can get kind of scared doing all that. And storms and stuff has always been a little bit scary. But sometimes, we're attracted to them for some reason. We just have to look. We just have to be a part of it for some reason. And today, Jesus talks about different storms, about the trials and tribulations that we all go through in our day from time to time. Sometimes this massive storm will hit our lives like an unexpected tornado. We could have a job loss, we could have a medical diagnosis, we could lose our loved one. Or we could have an automobile accident, or we could go through a pandemic like we're going through right now. All these things can leave us shocked, confused, and disoriented. When our world suddenly turns upside down, how can we get our bearings in it? And this is a real test of faith, not the times we're filled with constellations of prayer, but those times that God seems distant, that's the time that God is truly testing us. Many of the saints have said that it's precisely at this moment that Jesus is closest to us during these times. That's why it's so important to develop habits of prayer, worshiping God, receiving His sacraments, and these things do not change. The rest of the world may seem to fall apart, but our love of God and of His Son and the love of one another will never change. Some of the saints became saints precisely when their world fell apart, because they continued to love God and Jesus and other people in spite of everything. Love itself, though, was never enough. Their actions, it proved their love. So there are life circumstances when they seem to be spinning out of control, sometimes like the weather or during this pandemic. Perhaps we can remember today's parable. God's grace can come to fruition in any circumstance we find ourselves in. Today, let us take this challenge to heart, seeking to build ourselves on solid ground, and that is namely on Jesus Christ. Our trust is in the Lord, our God, and so we give our whole hearts to Him, knowing that He hears us and grants our prayers. We pray for the Church throughout the world, that we as its members and the leaders may be led by Christ to bring the gospel, the good news, to all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all people making laws in our country, that they may always respect the common dignity of all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an increase of faith in our own lives. We pray for a strengthening of that foundation that Jesus talks about today. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all couples preparing for marriage. And especially we pray as well for all children preparing for baptism, and for our confirmation students as well, that as they prepare for these sacraments, that they may be drawn closer to Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all of the people of the parish, for all those who have no one to pray for them, or for those who feel their prayers are going unheard. Pray that they may feel the presence of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have died. We pray that they may be raised up with Christ into heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, continue to uplift us and hold us in your arms. We ask all of these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world.
By your cross and resurrection,
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
body of Christ. Amen. The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you again for coming for Mass today. Just as a reminder that Madonna Varner's funeral Mass will be tomorrow here at Sacred Hearts at 10:30 a.m. So Madonna Varner, funeral Mass tomorrow at 10:30. And I was weighing whether or not to have the 8 o'clock Mass tomorrow, but I think we should probably have the Mass as well, just so we can distance ourselves a little bit more. I'm not sure how large the funeral is going to be. But we will have 8 o'clock Mass tomorrow, and then 10:30 Mass for Madonna Varner as well. The Lord be with you.
And
the Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Glorify the Lord by your life.
When tyrants tremble sick with fear, and hear their death bells ringing, when friends rejoice both far and near, how can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging, since love is Lord of all. singing. The peace of Christ makes fresh my heart, a fountain ever springing. All things are mine since I am his. How can I keep from singing? No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to that rock I'm clinging.